that in case I am using a program where I am having a lot of lists, but I do not need any extra space. जितनी स्पेस अवेलेबल है मेन मेमोरी में उससे ज्यादा मुझे चाहिए ही नहीं. द ड्रॉबैक ऑफ रेफरेंस काउंट मेथड आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट, आई एम सेइंग दिस इज अ स्पेस अवेलेबल इन मेमोरी. सपोजिटली दिस पर्टिकुलर सेल्स आर यूज्ड, सपोजिटली दीज आर यूज्ड फॉर द एंटायर प्रोग्राम एंड ड्यूरिंग द प्रोग्राम यूजिंग रिकर्सिव मेथड दीज स्पेसेस कुड बी फ्रीड using the reference count method, but I need not free them in between the program because as soon as the program ends, all the variables would automatically be freed. So this is an extra headache or extra thing for which the program is running. It would have automatically happened as soon as the program ends. So in case my program does not require extra memory, this is only a headache. A complete overhead? Yes, no?
Yes, ma'am.
So, how do I avoid
yes,
such
ma'am.
A situation? To avoid such a situation, what I do is, now if P is pointing to something, which is pointing to some other thing and which is a list and so on, in case this pointer is changed, I will be reducing the immediate pointer, the reference count, to say 0 or 1, whatever the case may be. If this is 0, I am not reducing further pointers right now. I just save this point. Jiska reference count 0 hai, I just save it in a list. Jin sabke reference count 0 hai. So, whenever my program requires more, or whenever operating system is running 4 or 5 applications that require more memory, in that case, or maybe a program is using 10 users and they are requiring more memory, in that case all the variables which were having reference count zeros, unke liye then I am calling the function, that is the reduce function, to free the memory. Understanding? Unless and until I require an available memory space, I will not be freeing this space. Are you all understanding what I'm trying to say?
Yes, ma'am.
In case a program has many users, it requires more memory, then all the variables with reference, all the locations with reference count 0 are recursively reduced, and in one attempt, instead of doing it in every attempt, jab bhi aap change kar rahe the, tab har baar pura recursive procedure call kar rahe the, instead of doing that, you just keep counting the reference counts. The variables whose reference counts are 0 are kept separately. Whenever more memory is required, then you recursively free the memory associated with them whose reference count then goes to 0. So this is a...
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes, dear.
Ma'am, how you are saying that it will be a recursive call? Because let's say peak, jahan pe point kar raha hai, wo 0 hua. तो उसके नेक्स्ट वाला जहाँ पे जो उसका नेक्स्ट वाला जिसको पॉइंट कर रहा है जीरो वाला, तो मैम उसकी फ्रीक्वेंसी कम हो जाएगी एक से, तो ये रिकर्सिव कैसे हुआ?
ऐसे रिकर्सिव हुआ, समझो, अंडरस्टैंड, अभी तो रिड्यूस फंक्शन लिखा था, उस रिड्यूस में से रिड्यूस कॉल करा था या नहीं?
यस मैम.
रिकर्सिव
अच्छा वैसे
व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय रिकर्सिव फंक्शन? व्हेन अ फंक्शन कॉल्स इटसेल्फ देन इट इज कॉल्ड रिकर्सिव फंक्शन. Understand what I'm
yes, ma'am.
I'll just explain once again. If matlab P is not null, in that case what you are doing is you are reducing the count of
reducing.
P. You are reducing the count. The in count. Case this count is 0. In that case, you were saying that R is P next and you are calling the reduce R. You were doing this?
Yes.
Now,
yes, ma'am.
Recursive call to this function. R points to some okay. other node, jo ki single hi list hai supposedly. To uska bhi count 0 ho gaya. It is pointing to 100 other nodes,
yes,
jinka count 0 ho gaya. Understanding? So this is recursive.
Yes,
jab tak last node ka count 0 na ho jaye, tab tak uske previous ko hum free nahi kar rahe hain. Pehle sare aage tak nodes free honge, phir P free hoga. Ye samajh aa raha hai sabko?
Yes, ma'am.
So what we were doing is, अब मॉडिफाइड मेथड में व्हाट वी वर डूइंग इज इफ दिस बिकम्स जीरो स्टोर p इन एन एरे और समथिंग बट व्हेनेवर आई एम रिक्वायर्ड टू फ्री द मेमोरी आई विल बी कॉलिंग इट रिकर्सिवली अगेन टू चेक टू व्हाट ऑल दे वर पॉइंटिंग. हमने सिर्फ p की वैल्यू ही चेंज करी पर उसके रिकर्सिव चेक को हमें तब भी लेटर ऑन करना ही पड़ेगा कि रिकर्सिवली और पॉइंटर्स आर अफेक्टिंग हाउ मेनी लिस्ट व्हिच आर गोइंग टू बी जीरो. Is it now clear to all?
Yes, ma'am.
Everybody, if there is still doubt, then please ask. The second method for automatic list management is garbage collection. All of you do know that in C++, automatic garbage collection goes on. What do I mean by garbage collection? The second method for your automatic list management. Again, I'm saying automatic so that whenever user requires, it is happening in that case. So what is garbage collection? Now, garbage collection is, I'm going to detect and reclaim free nodes using garbage collection. It is a system routine also called as garbage collector. It has two steps basically. One is a marking phase. We'll just understand what I'm saying by this. And another is a after marking phase comes the collection phase. So what happens in both of these phases is whenever a node is not required or pointed to by any else, जब भी एक नोड को किसी का पॉइंटर नहीं मिल रहा है, in that case it is marked. This location is marked. Again, whenever it has a collection of such locations, collection phase is I call the routine called as garbage collector. Garbage collector क्या करेगा? जितने भी marked nodes हैं, उन memory को free करके it will make it available for reuse. So you are not again and again and again calling the garbage collector. Marking phase goes on throughout the program. Collection phase is run only when extra memory is required. Garbage collection happens in two steps. I'm again saying. Marking phase keeps on marking the nodes which are no more used by a program. That can even be seen on compilation time. You will know which nodes are never going to be used again. कौन से variables आप dynamic memory के case में when you are having no more pointers to this particular location, you can never reuse this location. So you will know that this location is now not used by a program because nobody is pointing to this location. So marking phase में you keep on marking such variables. In the collection phase, जैसे कैसे marking होगी इन variables की, you actually write down the codes कि whenever a function ends, तो जितने भी variables उस function के अंदर थे, वो सारे variables की memory is marked. Function end हुआ, local variables की memory is marked. Just giving an example. Whenever a user or 10 users or 50 users come with the requirement of more memory, collection phase is run. All such variables are freed and available to the memory pool so that they can be now reused by whatever user was asking for them. Garbage collection also has a problem. What problem does garbage collection has and what is a possible problem that could be created in garbage collection that is having two phases that seems a perfect answer to any problem of your list management? What better can you think of? Anybody who can think of a better way of managing automatic list? You can. ये भी लोगों ने सोचे हुए methods हैं. You people can always think. I'm just asking. So in case I reach a situation called as thrashing. Thrashing is a situation in which my collection phase is running almost throughout the program. That is, either two possibilities are possible. That is, whenever I am going to run a collection phase, only one or two variables are freed. Wo free hue, memory mil gayi. Then, after that, again a user comes up. Again, one or two variables are freed in the collection phase. Again, a user comes up. And this keeps on happening again and again and again. If a collection phase is running again and again or almost throughout the program, that is called as thrashing. And we do not want thrashing to happen. Because this is an extra overhead. Instead of running the actual program, I am busy freeing up the space only. this is going to delay or slow down my actual program or actual application. So I do not want this to happen. How do I stop it? One way is, if I am having one single user, which is say requiring a space of 10 elements, and I am not, whenever I am calling a collection phase, if I am not able to give back say X amount of nodes free, if such a minimum amount of memory is not available free, then whatever user asked for extra memory, is that application is terminated. Agar user A ne supposedly manga tha ki I want space for 3 more variables, then minimum amount of memory could not be created in the collection phase, then user A's process is terminated. Jitne bhi variables A use kar raha tha, they are also made available to the memory pool. So that in case of future situation or need arises, in that case more space is available. To jis user ki wajah se wahan problem aayi, that user is terminated. So minimum collection phase should always return minimum amount of memory to be freed during the garbage collection phase. Is this clear to all?